You don't. And there are systems, because these are older bonds that have been on the market for a while, and the broker is finding an older bond that has a higher interest rate, but in fact, you are getting a lower price for it. And eventually, when it matures, between the interest rate and you're going to take a loss on the price, you're going to get a lower yield. This is complicated to explain, but the fact is you're going to get a lower yield than you actually would. So my advice always on these municipal bonds is to buy new issues. Don't buy older bonds. The older bonds may look attractive because they have a higher interest rate, but because you're paying more for them, in the end, it'll all even out. You're going to get the same rate that you would have had otherwise, but you could be cheated on the price.
And be careful if it says callable.
Callable, well, you have to see. Callable will say within a certain number of years, they can just take the bond away from you, and which will happen with a higher interest bond, because you can get the municipalities can get a lower interest rate today. So why should they keep a higher interest bond on the market when they can get it back? So they will call it away from you, and you will have to invest at a lower rate, and you may lose some money on it. So just buy the new bonds and don't mess around with the older ones.
What about IPOs?
IPOs, initial public offerings, new companies coming to the market. A lot of them, they just quit for a while. You know, after the bubble.
Down
oh my
bit.
Goodness!
Yeah.
Well, after all those internet companies burst in year 2000, and they all flopped, and then they started coming up again, and then we had this terrible, terrible, frightening meltdown in 08 and 09. You just didn't see them again. You're starting to see initial public offerings coming up, but do you know, first, the best ones go to the insiders.
Yeah.
And if a broker calls and offers you an initial public offering, it's because they couldn't sell them to the insiders. And what does that tell you?
Yeah.
And my feeling is that if a new company comes to market that you're interested in most cases, after 30 or 60 days, the price goes down. And I think you should watch it, track it, buy it if the price goes down, you'll get a better price. If the price doesn't go down, forget it. There'll be another new company coming to market at some other time.
In other words, there is no stock that your life should depend upon.
No, and there's always a new opportunity. But you know, Connie, this brings up the question again of stocks. I don't think that people should invest in individual stocks.
Yes.
Because you cannot know what is going on inside a company. I mean, look at the people who, a widows and orphan stock like Citibank. I mean, you think it's absolutely solid, and suddenly it crashes and it's worth almost nothing.
Yeah.
And look at people who might have bought AIG, you know, this huge insurance, global insurance company, and now it's broke. So you can never tell what is going on in an individual company. I don't buy individual stocks for that reason, because I don't want to be surprised. I know that over the long run, a mutual fund is going to be better.
Jane, almost you should be doing a series with this book, 1,200 pages, everything you ever wanted to know about money here, and we haven't even covered marriage, divorce, and what you do then, but it's all here. Thank you. Will you autograph my book?
I'd be thrilled to, Connie. Thank you so much for having
and
me.
And two of them, it's better than an exercise. Meanwhile, support your local library. Go in, take out a card. That's how they do get funding. It is our best democratic institution in America. Take a child with you. Teach them also about what a penny is worth. There's a great new book on Lincoln and the penny and what's behind the original penny. But meanwhile, let them learn. Take a book out, return it in the condition it was in, and on time. That's really part of making good citizens. And don't miss reading everything you need to know about money now. Jane Bryan Quinn, and you can see her on the web at, get her information there at janebryanquinn.com.
Yes.
And we'll see you next time. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Connie.
We're clear.
Anything you wanted to say, I didn't.